Malta was pretty nice, hardly any trees. As a little island, we just caught that bus everywhere. We'd run over from the hotel and catch the bus. And we'd be crowded and people would be pushing and needed to pay, and it was so cheap. We'd ride to Valletta every day and we'd go sit at this cafe and drink beer and eat a different dish all the time. And we started to know the waiter and it was a lot of fun.
Well, Malta is pretty nice and good weather and nice people. It was just fun. Good food. I run Malta by bus mainly, but sometimes by taxi or rent a van.
The food was really good and we eat fish every day. And we went to this really nice place called the Barracuda. And it overhung the water and Ester and I had, can't remember how many course, maybe about 4 or 5 maybe. Ate some fish and had crepe Suzette in the end and a little champagne. And it was really romantic and probably one of the best meals I've ever had. And then at night, we were close to there, it was the boulevard. And you go and walk up the boulevard and go and eat some ice cream and walk along the water. We had a really good time in Malta. I think it was our best vacation ever.
And we went to Gozo too. That was kind of fun. It was a really long bus ride. That was nice. And a few days before we left, on a Saturday night I think, we went to a sexy love beach party. And that was fun. And, we left kind of early and there were nowhere buses, so we were looking for a taxi, but there was no one on the road, and except for people that were going to the party. So we ended up walking to a hotel and getting some ice cream while waiting for a taxi. But the main thing is that I got pregnant.
We went to Fort St. Angelo and it wasn't even protected. You could just walk in there and go anywhere. If we had a flashlight, I'm sure we could walk down into that fort, but we just didn't.
The food was really good, and the day we got there, we went to the Italian restaurant by the old harbor of St. Julian's, and it was really good. We had fish. After that, we kept going to a restaurant below it, which was also Italian, and they sold a really good dish of the pasta that looked like a little flotai with cream sauce and vodka and smoked salmon and caviar. And that was really good.
We went and ate lunch there at one of the oldest restaurants in the island and had some really good food and beer. It was hot that day.
So we went to the Hypogeum, which is the oldest man-made structure in the world, I guess. It's older than Stonehenge. And it's just in an urban area. Inside a block of houses. I happened to find it when they constructed it or something. And we thought we could just go there, but apparently you had to reserve months in advance. And we hadn't, of course. But we didn't know that, so we went there. We rented a van by the hotel. And the driver drove us there. And we heard that you had to reserve up front, and it was this American family, Maltese American, I guess, and they had 2 spare tickets because they had some people that didn't go. So we could go instead, and we went in there, and it was really nice. And there was some, probably some temple from a fertility cult.